Hi everyone, my name is Javier Perez-Garcia and I am a postdoc scholar at Cardenas Lab at Stanford University. In this video, I want to briefly summarize the main findings of our work recently published in the Allergy journal entitled The Nasal Microbiome and Associations with Environmental Exposures and Respiratory Health. The aim of this study was to identify differences in the nasal microbiome associated with air pollution, meteorological conditions, and respiratory health. We analyzed nasal swabs from 416 adolescents from the Project Viva cohort, from where we isolated genomic DNA and profiled the microbiome by targeted sequencing of the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. From all participants, we retrospectively collected data about environmental exposure to air pollution, temperature, humidity, and greenness at different time points relative to sample collection. We also collected information about respiratory outcomes such as asthma, high fever, heart allergen sensitization, IgE, FeNO, and lung function. We tested for association of environmental exposures and respiratory health with the nasal microbiome at three different levels, including bacterial diversity, nasotypes or clusters, and the abundance of specific bacterial genera. Briefly, as we can observe in the plot on the left, we reported that short to medium term environmental exposure to NO2 and humidity were positively associated with bacterial diversity, while exposures to O3 and temperature showed a negative association. Among all respiratory traits, we observed that high fever was associated with increased bacterial diversity as shown in the box plot of the right. Regarding the cluster analysis, we identified that Project Viva participants could be clustered into six different groups or nasotypes shown in this taxabar plot on the left. After doing a pairwise comparison among all clusters, we observed that participants whose nasal microbiome was dominated by Moraxella were exposed to higher temperature and humidity and lower levels to O3 compared to all the other participants. We also observed that dominance of Staphylococcus was positively associated with higher allergen sensitization compared to propionibacterium dominance. Finally, we reported that the abundance of multiple bacterial genera were associated with environmental exposures and respiratory health. We observed that six of these bacterial genera represented in this plot were associated both with exposures such as PM2.5, NO2, and temperature, and respiratory traits such as wheezing, FeNO, and lung function, including common bacteria in the nasal microbiome such as Staphylococcus or Corynebacterium. In conclusion, we reported that the nasal microbiome was associated in terms of diversity, nasotypes, and composition with both environmental exposures and respiratory health in children. Thanks so much for watching this video, and I invite you to check the full manuscript.